friends, new acquaintances, relatives. It's just awesome to see these people come together tonight. So before I share some comments, I just ask you to look around and just look at this special group of people. Look at people who've been with us a long time, and look at people, the young ones who've just joined us. And this is what I think our Lord planned in His master plan many years ago. God's most precious gifts include family and fellowship. Tonight we have both. Thank you for making the effort to share this very special weekend with the Kennedy and Shook families. Each of us know Hayley and Palmer in our own special ways. Many of us have witnessed their relationship mature into what our Lord intended when marriage was given its special purpose in His plan for us. I'd like to recognize Anita and Derek and thank them for the blessing that they gave Hayley to marry our son Palmer. I think he'll make you proud. Karen and I and all the Kennedy clan are thrilled with welcoming Hayley to our family. I understand that with protocol that toasts are for after dinner, but I would like to make a break with that tradition momentarily and offer two toasts this evening to start the evening out. On behalf of Anita, Derek, and Karen, join me in raising a glass for the bride and groom. May God bless you and guide your path in all you do. I would also like to recognize my daughter and her fiance, Sam, who will be getting married on August 1. Many of you here tonight will not be able to attend the second wedding this summer. Your prayers for this wedding and for their life together will help Sam and Laura Catherine start their journey together on the right path. So please join me in the second toast of the evening. And on behalf of Mary, Ted, and Karen, please join me in raising a glass to the soon-to-be bride and groom. May God bless you and guide your path in all we do, in all you do. Palmer, Hayley, Laura, Sam, and Kyle. I would ask that you look around this room at the family that is gathered. The parents, the grandparents, the uncles, the aunts, and the cousins. As y'all move forward in different places and go through different phases of your lives, please always remember that family is a constant in your life. Keep and cherish relationships with brothers and sisters, brother-in-laws and sister-in-laws, as many things will change, but God willing, your family never will. We are thankful for Granny Ray, grandparent of Hayley, and looking forward to having her at our service tomorrow. We thank her for the role and the preparation that she has played in this marriage. I'd like to thank Mama B and Jim for being here tonight and the role you played in the preparation for this marriage. While Palmer's grandfather, Papa, passed away a number of years ago, and his grandmother in Mobile, Baba, was unable to attend tonight, I know they are both very proud of you and wish you the happiness that they found in their marriage and life together. Papa would say to you, Palmer, you've done well for yourself. You're already a lovely bride. Cherish her always and take care of her. And to my bride, Karen, we'll soon celebrate 31 years together. Thank you for sharing the gifts of marriage and the joy that family has brought me and our life. I hope that Hayley and Palmer may remember the best of what Anita and Derek and Karen and I have tried to provide as parents. Thank you for the two of you for who you are and whose you are. And now the blessing. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, thank you for the special evening. May this evening and tomorrow's ceremony go as you would intend, and may we honor you in all we do. Thank you for this dinner and the opportunity to share it with those that love and support your children, Hayley and Palmer. And we ask that you bless this time together tonight. Derek, Anita, Palmer McCarrick. Thank you for allowing us the gift of our children to present them at your altar tomorrow as you bless this marriage with the spiritual richness that only a belief and walk with you may provide. Now please honor each of our prayers as we all pause independently for our own thanksgiving at this time. Thank you and praise you, Lord. And all God's people said,
amen.
Thank you guys for being here tonight. Thank y'all.
Good job.
These pieces broken and scattered, and mercy gathered, mended and told, empty-handed but not forsaken. I've been set free. Once was lost, but now
You may all be seated. Family and friends, we are gathered together in the presence of God and one another to witness and bless the joining together of Palmer Kennedy and Hayley Shook in Christian marriage. The covenant of marriage was established by God, who created us male and female for each other, and by its nature is a binding agreement between two persons and God in heaven for as long as they are both breathing on this planet. In his sacrificial love for God's children, Jesus lived and died and gave us an example for the love of a husband and a wife. So with that, before we go any further here in this place, let us pray together, let us thank God together, and let us hear from God's word together.
Will you bow your heads with me? Dear Father, we thank you so much for this beautiful day, the day that you created for Palmer and Hayley to be one. We thank you for these precious families who have raised them, Father, to know you and to love you with all their hearts. We thank you that your word declares that two are better than one, and today these two precious individuals become stronger because they are knitted in your love. And Lord, we ask this very day that you would just enter into this place. Father, we pray that you would come and you would be real. We would be encouraged by what happens in these next moments as these two beautiful children are joined together. Lord, we ask that you would cover them with your love. Father, that the fruits of the Spirit would be in their home each and every day. Lord, I ask that you would give Palmer such a beautiful love for Hayley, Lord, that he would always love her as you love your church. And Father, we pray that Hayley would respect Palmer and be all that he needs as she submits to him as his wife. And Lord, we so expect amazing things, and we look forward to how they will bring you honor and glory with this marriage because they love you. And Lord, we pray that we would, as their friends and family, always remember to encourage them, to lift them up in prayer. And Lord, may we never be the same because we've gotten to witness your precious mystery and miracle that's happened today as they've joined together. Bless this time in your holy and precious name. And everybody said, amen. Amen. We'll read from Hosea chapter 2, verses 19 through 20. And I will betroth you to me forever. I will betroth you to me in righteousness and in justice, in steadfast love and in mercy. I will betroth you to me in faithfulness, and you shall know the Lord.
Hosea tells of a day when the Lord will make all things right, when we will be his bride, when we will be fully joined together to him in faithfulness. And in the meantime, we have this. We have Christian marriage where we are joined together as husband and wife, always pointing one another to the Lord. Very simply, to fall in love means to look at the other person and say, I see who God is making you into, and I am so blessed and honored to be a part of that. And it's with that ultimate hope that we look to one another, that we look to our spouse, and we say, Jesus, here on this day and forevermore, for as long as we both shall live. Amen. The model for the marriage relationship is God's love for us in Jesus Christ. And on the cross, he set that example for us of commitment, of sacrifice. Yet it is ultimately in his resurrection that we have any hope whatsoever. And it is only because of the resurrection that you get to hope to be the wife that you want to be. And because of the resurrection that you have any chance of being the husband that you want to be. And it is with this ultimate hope in Christ that Palmer and Hayley have come together on this day in the presence of all of us to say, I do, and I will, and I promise forevermore. So I ask you now, in the presence of God and these people, to declare your intention to enter into union with each other through the grace of Jesus Christ, who calls you into union with himself as acknowledged in your baptism. So, Palmer, do you promise to have Hayley to be your wife, to live together in holy marriage? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
I promise.
Hayley, do you promise to have Palmer to be your husband, to live together in holy marriage? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live?
I promise.
That said, who gives this woman to be married to this man?
Her mother and I.
So Palmer, we are going to make vows. Hayley, we are going to make vows here on this day. And what we are doing in this place is not witnessing current love. This is promise of future love for as many days as you have together. So Palmer, repeat after me. Hayley Marie Shook.
Hayley Marie Shook.
Today and every day after.
Today and every day after.
I am honored and overjoyed.
I am honored and overjoyed
to take you as my beloved wife.
To take you as my beloved wife.
By God's strength.
By God's strength.
I promise to love you.
I promise to love you.
As Christ has, does, and will forever love his church.
As Christ has, does, and will forever love his church.
To humbly lead.
To humbly lead.
And tirelessly pursue. And
tirelessly pursue.
And willingly serve you always.
And willingly serve you always.
In seasons of ease and seasons of trial.
In seasons of ease and seasons of trial.
Seasons joyful and seasons of pain.
Seasons joyful and seasons of pain.
And to put your interests.
And to put your interests.
And your welfare before my own.
And your welfare before my own.
I promise always to be.
I promise always to be.
Both strong for you and tender with you.
Both strong for you and tender with you.
To both protect and provide for you.
To both protect and provide for you.
As God enables me.
As God enables me.
I promise to be both your lover and dearest friend.
I promise to be both your lover and dearest friend.
To be faithfully yours and yours alone.
To be faithfully yours and yours alone.
And to cherish you.
And to cherish you.
All the days of my life until death do us part.
All the days of my life until death do us part.
Hayley, repeat after me. Palmer Born Kennedy, today and always.
Palmer Born Kennedy, today and always.
I take you as my husband.
I take you as my husband.
I promise to honor you, respect you.
I promise to honor you, respect you.
And love you with all my strength.
And love you with all of my strength.
I promise to always encourage you in your desires.
I promise to always encourage you in your desires.
To live out the Lord's calling in your life.
To live out the Lord's calling in your life.
I promise to fight for you and with you.
I promise to fight for you and with you.
During seasons of good health and bad.
During seasons of good health and bad.
I promise to choose you and choose love.
I promise to choose you and choose love.
In times of trial.
In times of trial.
Just as Christ has always chosen me.
Just as Christ has always chosen me.
I promise to love you transparently.
I promise to love you transparently.
And to give myself wholly to you.
And to give myself wholly to you.
I promise to be your Ezer, your helpmate.
I promise to be your Ezer, your helpmate.
All the days we are here on this earth.
All of the days we are here on this earth.
Until the Lord takes us to our eternal home.
Until the Lord takes us to our eternal home.
These rings are an outward visible sign of an inward and spiritual truth and grace, signifying to us the union between Jesus Christ and his church. And so, Lord, we pray that you would bless them and the giving of these rings, that they who wear them may live in your peace and continue in your favor all the days of their life. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Palmer, take her ring and repeat after me as you put it on her left hand. Hayley, I give you this ring.
Hayley, I give you this ring.
As a sign of my vow.
As a sign of my vow.
And with all that I am.
And with all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you.
I honor you.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Palmer, I give you this ring.
Palmer, I give you this ring.
As a sign of my vow.
As a sign of my vow.
And with all that I am.
And with all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you.
I honor you.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
As their first act as husband and wife, Palmer and Hayley are going to enjoy communion together. And his last meal with his disciples, Jesus said, as you've seen me, as you've followed me, as you've witnessed the way that I have loved you, so love one another. So let's do that together.
you say well done. I want to be welcomed in. I want to feel your love like sunshine on my resurrected skin. I want to hear the music play. I want to hear the trumpet sound. I want to hear you call my name and watch my feet lift off the ground. So I will run. No, and I won't quit chasing your heart. Just like David did. I want to hear you call me son, be counted as your faithful friend. I want to see your eyes like fire. I want to see the scars that bled. Oh, won't you take me higher to the place where angels fear to tread? So I will.
You have declared your consent and your vows before God. And this congregation, this group of family and friends who have said, we're going to be here on the day that this happens. So may God confirm your covenant and fill you both with his grace. Palmer and Hayley, you've given yourselves to one another by the giving of vows, the exchanging of rings, the joining of your hands. So I announce to you that they are, in fact, husband and wife in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Spirit. Therefore, let no man try to separate what God has joined together. Amen? Amen. Let's pray together. Oh God, you have so consecrated the covenant of marriage that in it is represented the covenant between Christ and his church. And we pray that Palmer and Hayley would never forget that they are a beacon of light and of hope to a world that doesn't really know love apart from you. We pray, Lord, for a blessing on their home, that they would, for all of their days, keep their marriage covenant and so grow in love and godliness together, and that their home may be a haven of blessing and of peace through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. May God the Eternal keep you in love with one another so that the peace of Christ may abide in your home. So go from this place to serve God and your neighbor in all that you do. Palmer, you may kiss your bride. Yeah. We can celebrate. You can just read it if you want to. See you guys coming together. So may I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Palmer, Bourne, Kennedy.
Ladies and gentlemen, the first time in the first dance, Mr. and Mrs. Palmer.
Baby, things ain't been going my way, but I need you. For you. Thank you.
bunch of them.
It's gonna be a
chances of somebody falling down.
What are
they? Very good. Heels, a lot of heels.
Oh Lord.
Good shot.
Is it gonna catch on the line?
Megan was like, push it over.
Watch the line.
Is it gonna catch? Hold on, is it gonna catch?
You're gonna get through, Hayley.
He does beat everyone.
He does beat everyone.
Y'all better stab.
Watch it over all their heads.
Okay, ready? Do I just get three?
Okay.
Yeah, we'll see.